welcome to Downtown Alive, the monthly program of the Reading Downtown Improvement District. I'm your host, Laura Reppert, Special Events Coordinator for the Downtown Improvement District. And we are starting off our show here with our Hidden in Plain Sight segment with Polityka from the Berks History Center. And since it's holiday time, we're talking about holidays downtown. And when you think about holidays and holiday decorations downtown, there's one place that you think of.
Pomeroy's.
Absolutely, Pomeroy's. And instead of saying hidden in plain sight today, it's hidden in our memories because Pomeroy's isn't there anymore.
No more.
So.
Yeah.
But what we're going to talk about today is go over some Christmases of a bygone time, some big things that happened around here, some things that happened as far as that people always remembered from Christmas in downtown Reading. And I have a nice little slideshow presentation that hopefully we'll all enjoy. So,
I'm excited to see some of these
are we ready to go?
We are ready.
You saw in the very beginning, you saw the heading here that said Shop in Reading on Santa Claus Lane.
Mm-hmm.
Well, where was that? Santa Claus Lane happened to be Penn Street. Because our first picture here shows that the day after Thanksgiving, they had the decoration lighting ceremony. And then when that actually happened on Black Friday, and you see Pomeroy's in the background, all the lights are lit up on Penn Square. All the stores that had their Christmas advertisements, their storefront windows, which was something that people love to do, was window shop.
Mm-hmm.
They all unveiled their window shopping.
So on what now is Black Friday, that was the day that downtown Reading would light up with all the decorations.
It all lit up at that time. So that was actually
was
a very,
really
very interesting
cool
thing.
Yeah.
And in the background, this is actually a drawing from the Reading Eagle and 1938, but you see all the lights lit up in Pomeroy's, and we're going to see a kind of a neat picture from a few years later on that looks really, really nice. Our next picture, we've talked about this before when we were talking about some stuff on Penn Street, 1939, December 21st, I'm sorry. The movie Gone with the Wind premiered here in Reading.
Yes.
Now, I was a little incorrect the last time, I have to say. The last time that we talked about this, I had one of the cities, I gave someone credit that didn't deserve it and someone didn't get credit. The cities that were all in the 1939 premiere of Gone with the Wind were Los Angeles, Atlanta, Boston, New York, Washington, Houston, Cincinnati, and Reading.
Uh-huh.
So I said Indianapolis the last time, so forgive me.
Sorry, Cincinnati.
Yep, Cincinnati got it, yeah. So. But what we have in this picture here that we're showing is we have a picture of an ad from the Reading Eagle from 1939 where the merchants downtown had their Gone with the Wind themed promotions.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so you can see Gone with the Wind prints. The Jeanette shop had gowns from the Gone with the Wind. Everyone had a little bit of something in it.
And this was right before Christmas.
This was right before Christmas,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, they wanted to make sure it was a 1939 movie for the, I guess, and there was only a select few cities, and we were one of them.
Hmm.
So we beat out Philadelphia for a change.
Yeah.
So our next photo, we're going to move up a little bit further in time, and we're going to look at 1950s. You see now the square has the traffic circle in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see any cars here because it's a slow exposure light. Photograph, and all these little lights that you see, that's actually cars whizzing by. There's only one car that was stationary at the square. But you see the Christmas decorations lit up, you see everything well lit, and in the back you also see Pomeroy's. Now Pomeroy's originally was founded by three men that worked in retail in Hartford.
Okay.
It was George Pomeroy, who's the name that we most identify with, but it was Hosiah Dives and Josh Stewart, and Dives was from England, and Stewart was from Scotland. So the three of them were looking for an opportunity to get into the retail business for themselves, and another merchant in the Hartford area told them Reading was a place that you really want to go and look. And so they came here. 1876 is when they opened their first store on 500 block of Penn Street. They moved it shortly after that to the 400 block next to like where Whitner's it was at that time. And then in 1882, they moved up onto the 600 block of Penn Street.
Huh.
And we'll have a nice picture of that coming up very shortly. But the next picture that we're showing you here This is down at the 400 block. You're looking towards, if you're looking on the sidewalk here, you're looking right at the Marvell Ranch, what you would know today.
Uh-huh.
And across the street would be where the American House is. And back then, in the 60s, that was Shirelli Brothers. They had musical instruments there. They had TVs there. It was, you know, that was the type of store that was. But yeah, you see a lot of people on the sidewalk doing their shopping in the evening.
And
you see WEEU 850.
Reading beer vintage sign there. Reach for Reading.
You bet. Indeed. And you see all the Christmas decorations. You know, well, you see a lot of people out in the streets.
Uh-huh.
Really getting out there and, you know, getting into the festive mood of the year. So this one isn't a picture. The next one that we're showing, this is not a picture of Christmas time, but this is the original Pomeroy's building. And this was the building at 1900.
Okay.
In the corner. This is the one we all kind of remember. But this is what it originally looked like, and you can see the horse and wagons down the bottom. The building next to it along Penn Street, that was the original building from 1882.
Okay.
Now, one thing that you always remembered when we used to have the holiday parade, which we just had recently, the fire engine would come down, and the way that Christmas was officially on in Reading was the fire engine would come down in front of Pomeroy's. They would put the ladder up to the sixth floor, and a very adventurous Santa Claus would climb up into the sixth floor window, and that was where he set up residence for the whole Christmas season.
I have heard that that was the whole Christmas display.
Toyland was something to behold. And the next couple of photographs I have from some friends of mine that actually gave me a couple of photographs of Santa Claus.
Okay.
You know, from Pomeroy's. This was from back in the 60s. So I'm... The next two photographs that I have here, a couple of my friends had generously given me permission to use some photographs. So after we go after that, then we're going to start looking at Pomeroy's. These are some color photographs from Pomeroy's in the 60s. You now see the front portion of the store modernized. You know, that was done in 1961. You see all the candles in the windows.
Mm-hmm.
It looks really, really impressive. This was like a rainy night. Photographer went out there late at night, was kind of deserted on a Sunday night, and he took some photographs. Mm-hmm. See all the candles on the
beautiful.
In the windows. Getting a little close.
And that was their own tree out front.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Yeah, and that tree was
a city tree.
Yep, that was right on front of the entrance on South 6th Street.
Right over the marquee. Yeah.
Right over the marquee. And I remember going in that store many a time. And again, their window shopping. It was always a competition from store to store who could put the best window display together. I mean, that was something that everyone prided themselves on.
Mm-hmm.
So when we're looking forward, now we're looking at this next photograph that we have, and we are looking at shoppers making their way into Pomeroy's. And like again, this is 1961, and you can just see all the bustling activity that was on the street back at that time. You see all the bows on the light standards.
Mm-hmm.
You see the tree over top of the marquee also as well. And our next photograph, we are showing you a vintage picture from 1920. And this says, Dives, Pomeroy's, and Stewart, Merry Christmas. So when you're looking at this, this is 1920. The store became officially Pomeroy's in 1923. George Pomeroy bought out the estate of Johiah Dives.
Huh.
And so then he actually, then the store just became Pomeroy's. And shortly after that, then I think he passed away, but he had already turned the business over to his son, George Jr. So.
And for 1920, what an incredible amount of work for
signs
of that size. And
For a man actually to put a Merry Christmas over top of the sign of Dives, Pomeroy's, and Stewart. But yeah, you can see in this picture, you see all the windows that are open on the mezzanine section, and then down below, like I said, this looks like
a block. You can see everything's lit up.
Yeah, it was a very, very festive time at that time of the year downtown Reading. Mm-hmm. I mean, I remember it very well in my my youth also as well. As we close these photographs out, we have a couple more photographs from Santa Claus days because that was what everyone remembered. I mean, my first memories of downtown Reading were Pomeroy's. I was really excited to get the ride on the escalator. That was the first time I ever rode on an escalator.
Uh-huh.
So that was kind of a neat thing. So, and, it was like a very, very special time back then. You know, it's sad that it's gone, but, the memories will last forever.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the nice part about
it.
So that's kind of what I have. So
Thank you very much, Rick. It was great. Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
our motorcycle escort from the Reading Police Department. Followed by the Reading Police Honor Guard, a ceremonial unit that represents the men and women of the Reading Police Department. The Honor Guard participates in parades and memorial ceremonies to honor the bravery of fallen brothers and sisters. Let's give them a big round of applause. We also have the Reading Police Youth Academy. Their mission is to provide a career and community-based program guided for young adults working toward a better path for their futures through training, leadership, teamwork, discipline, community service, and career exploration in law enforcement. Now please welcome the 2018 Wyomissing Area Spartan Marching Band, led by Senior Drum Major McKinley Morris and Junior Drum Major Alex Tharp. Additional student leadership includes section leaders Maddie Hawley and Ellie Ramirez, percussion captains Tyler Sharra and Emma Morris, and color guard captains Cassie Garabowski and Sophia Strombakis. Spartan Marching Band performs in football games, parades, and in field show competitions. They've been part of the local theater community for more than 100 years. In December, RCT will present the classic musical, Annie. The show features some of the greatest musical theater hits ever written, including Tomorrow. Festival, the Robesonia Jack Frost Parade, the Reading Holiday Parade, West Reading Armed Forces Day Parade and local Memorial Day parades. Sopahawken Junior Senior High School Marching Band is proud to perform today and wishes everyone happy holidays. Township Senior High School Marching Band is a co-curricular unit with 145 members. The band actively participates in all home and away football games, various local marching band shows, and parades. In April, members of the band will represent Exeter Township community in the 66th Annual Parade of Nations in Norfolk, Virginia. The band is thrilled to return to Reading Holiday Parade and wishes everyone warm season's greetings.